favorites. Milk Delights. Chocoberries. Jelly Gems.
Ugh. Where is it? Where is it? Where's the Choco Lemon Candy, Mr. Coco?
There you go.
Why are the Choco Lemons kept so far in the back?
This candy isn't very popular, Logic Gate. So I keep it behind the others.
Really? But it's so yummy. And how do you know that it isn't popular, Mr. Coco?
That's simple. I arrange the jars by collecting and analyzing data on how many people like each type of candy.
Huh? What do you mean by collecting and analyzing data?
Have you ever noticed that popular chocolates and toys are always kept in easily accessible places in supermarkets? Well, it's not a coincidence. Supermarkets collect data on our favorite items. And based on this data, the popular ones are kept in aisles that are visible and easily accessible. This is possible with the help of data analysis. Data analysis is the process of examining collected data and drawing conclusions from it. For example, let's take a look at a student's report card. All the scores that the student received on assignments and tests are data. The teacher collects this data, assigns a final grade based on the data, and concludes how the student is doing and whether they need help. Now, let's consider this chart and analyze the data. This chart shows the number of leaves on trees during each month of the year and what color those leaves are. By analyzing the data in the chart, we can see exactly when these changes in leaf count and color happen during the year. We can conclude, for example, that the trees are greenest and leafiest in the month of July. We can analyze data to predict certain outcomes. However, it's very important to be precise and consistent when collecting that data. If our data is insufficient, then our analysis will be inaccurate, and our predictions might be wrong. For example, if we count the leaves every day in June, but only remember to count them three times in July, our predictions will be inaccurate. Consistent and sufficient data collection will help us with analysis and accurate prediction. Now, look at the trees outside your window and figure out what season it is. I check the data on which candies sell out fast and arrange the popular ones in the front row. It just makes it so much easier for my customers to find them.
Oh, I didn't know about this.
And sold out. Looks like we might have a new customer favorite. Now I'll have to keep this in the front row too.
Aww. Raymond.
The trolls learned how to collect data and make accurate predictions from it. Here's an exciting challenge for you. Ask your parents or guardians to show you weather reports from the past week. Then predict what the weather will be like tomorrow.